The reason you are receiving this pre-recorded message is to notify you that IRS has issued an arrest warrant against you. Right now you and your physical property both are being monitored, and it's very important that I do hear back from you as soon as possible before we proceed further in any legal manner.
Scary sounding, but it's not the IRS. The scam of fraudulent IRS calls has increased recently, where the operator, as you heard, says you have an arrest warrant out for unpaid taxes.
Definitely unsettling, but these phone calls or emails, they're from criminals that are trying different ways to use technology to steal your identity and the money, of course, right out of your wallet.
Yeah, they keep trying. And joining us is Stan Prager from Go Geeks in East Longmeadow to tell us more. And Stan, you actually came home one day and that recording was on your machine.
That's correct.
Did you panic?
No, I did not panic.
You did not.
And there is a phone number that they leave after the clip that was played on here. There is an actual phone number. And, you know, if you want to have fun, you can call them back. but the fact is there are many people, of course, who are frightened by this. And there are people out there where it's a shotgun approach, right? So let's say you had some kind of tax problems. Mm-hmm. Maybe you had a tax lien or something in the past, and you happen to get this call. It's going to seem even more authentic. Mm-hmm. And this is just like the calls people get. Maybe they're having a problem with their computer and they get a fraudulent call. So this is the case here. It's a shotgun call. It's made to everybody, but people who believe it will call back and they're going to ask you for to verify your social security number. They're going to try to get your bank account information. They're going to work out some kind of payment arrangement with you, whatever, so they can get money from you in some sense. Okay.
Of course.
So that's critical. There's also a lot of these that are coming in via email. And the email ones are just as nefarious. The email ones sometimes actually have an attachment. It says to click on the attachment, and the attachment has malware that
releases
into your
system. Don't click on the attachment. All right.
Or it'll have a link. And you click on a link, it'll go to a site that mimics the IRS.gov website. Mm. And there'll be a place to fill in your social security, date of birth, etc. So it's an identity theft. I mean, there's a number of different purposes when they do this. Interestingly, they recently busted a call center in India, where they actually had a couple of hundred people there trained to do this, and they were specifically trained to speak with an American accent in order to pull this off.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
This is some serious criminal work, right? I mean, imagine you have these training sessions for weeks to get people who have Indian accents to speak with an American accent so that they can be more authentic. The clip that was played here, which I recorded with
my
iPhone.
Sounds like a computer voice.
They didn't
use a human to do that.
That's correct. That's a robotic voice. That's called a voice recognition software, where you speak into it, and then it translates it into another.
So if the person has an accent, you never know, because it's translated into robot accent.
Well, yeah. So this one's a robot, but there are real human ones that was coming from the call center.
Well, okay. And also, the IRS is not going to call you.
That's
more
correct.
Than likely
Never.
Not going to email you. It's always through the mail that they'll get a hold of you. And it's not like they say, pay something right now or else. You generally have a decent amount of time to resolve your issues with the IRS.
That's correct.
Despite what many people fear.
Yes, that's correct. And you'll be reached by mail. And if you were in communication with the IRS for some reason, an agent called you, they would have an agent number and a specific line. What's interesting about this clip you guys played here is that the number they left isn't even an 800 number. It's a regular.
Did you call it?
No. I did not.
I couldn't be bothered.
Yeah, I've done it in the past, though. I have called these kinds of fraudulent
things. Just
to see how far they'll go.
I
didn't do it this particular time. But you know, trust me, if the IRS was going to leave you a number, it'd at least be an 800 number. It wouldn't be a regular, call. Area code.
A 413 number.
Yeah, 413 number, exactly. So don't fall for this. And really, the IRS says go to their website. There is a way to report these activities. But more importantly, there's a way to contact the IRS. If you are worried, if you think, geez, I want to make sure this isn't happening, contact the IRS directly first and verify that something would be legitimate before you acted and returned a phone call to a criminal.
Yeah, that's the key. Always
great advice.
If there's any question.
Stan Prager, thank you very much.
All right, Stan.
Stay safe.
Thanks.